back to go down and play it.
Welcome in the name of the Motorsport Jukaldo, and thank you for coming. My special welcome today will be to the International Jury, representative for all members. Greetings to Mr. Magnussen from Sweden, the president of the FIM Motocross Commission, and the president of the International Jury of this event, Mr. Hofruis from Netherlands, and the gentlemen of the OMK and ADSC. Many thanks for the confidence that we can organize the Motocross World Championship for national teams here in Geildorf. With much pleasure, greetings to the guests of honor, sponsors and friends of our club, and the delegations of a lot of motocross racing organizers of all countries. A hearty welcome to the ladies and gentlemen of television, broadcasting and press, the representatives of industry, also managers and riders. A lot of thanks to all who helped to organize this great event. Special thanks to all helpers who will get the best to have a very good race today. Much success and races without any accident for all riders. And for all visitors, exciting races here on the beautiful Wacht in Geildorf.
Since 1981, American riders have wrapped up the motocross season with a trip to Europe for World Team Championship competition. And since 1981, the American teams have been the best. Four straight team titles in the 250cc event, the Trophy Donations, and four straight in the 500cc event, the Motocross Donations. 1985, however, was to have been a different story due to a brand new format. A single event consisting of three motos with 125s, 250s, and 500s all racing together.
Well, the new format is three riders per country riding each in a different class, a 125, a 250, and a 500. And the scoring is done individually in each class is scored individually. A rider could be, for example, in fourth place on a 125, and he still could score for first place for his class. And then they make the best, they take the best six results out of the nine heats.
Geldorf, Germany played host to the new event, and a huge crowd of European enthusiasts turned out for the festivities, including a large contingent of American supporters. They all came to see if the Americans could make it five in a row. As was expected, when the gate dropped in all three motos, the Big Boar 500 stormed to the front, followed by a mixture of 250s and 125s. In the first moto, Ron Lachine, number three, suffered a horrible start, but still managed to work his way up to 12th overall and third in the 125 class.
Gebackene Weltmeister aus der Königsklasse. Und dann dahinter diese Fahrer, die ihre Maschinen beherrschen.
Auf Platz 10. Ich habe also das Mikrofon an den Schnitt.
well. The Australian driver is in 20th place. Rob Anderson is still there in 25th place for Great Britain. Ronnie Lachine is in 26th position, immediately behind Andrews.
World 500cc champion, leading the race, David Daly of America in second place. Was in third position, but it's now Jeff Ward in third position. 12th place goes Heinz Kinnegatner, then Kees van der Ven, Jackie Vermont, Jackie Martin, Roland Diepold, but the leader of the race, the world champion himself, David Thorpe of Great Britain.
Mit Nummer 7, Sauber Billy, dann Ford, dann Kindergartner, Van der Ven, Rinaldi, Martin, Schein, Soledad, William, Jespersen, Karim, Streubert, Dave Streubert, der hey, Amerikaner vorne und als dritter dann die Start Nummer 7.
Well, just to bring you up to date again, America moving in dramatically then when both David Bailey and Jeff Ward pass the British World Champion Dave Thorpe. But their third rider well down the field, that's Ronnie Lachine. We've seen him have two falls so far and he's in 31st position at the moment. Rob Andrews, the second rider in the British team, is lying in 29th place at the moment. But Bailey and Ward heading off the rest of the world just at the moment in first and second places. Dave Thorpe in third position with Heinz Kinnegatner, Kees van der Ven and Jackie Martin following.
Climbing, he is in 16th position for America.
America. And then we go to Finland. Finland have Pekka Vekkonen in ninth place. They have Jukka Lindemann in 16th position. And Holland have Chase van der Ven in third place. With Jurgen van Doren in 15th position. David Farber also in there at 11th place. So no doubt a battle between USA, Finland and Holland, but the Great Britain stays strong, leading the race.
Thank you, and David Thorpe once again the leader of the second race.
Britain placed in 17th position after the first race, bear in mind that is from two rides only, and this picture will alter hopefully if they finish all six rides out of the three races, with six rides only to count from nine. So Britain still not out of it at the moment. They saw leading the second race, having won the first one. David Bailey from the USA in second position, Kate Van der Ven from Holland in third place, and Kenny Gardner in fourth. And Mark Alonso there in fifth place, Jackie Vimmel in sixth position, Jeff Ward in seventh, Gert-Jan van Doren of Holland in eighth place. So Holland catching up nicely now behind America.
Bailey there in third place, Ward in fourth. Then we've got the rest of the Dutch team following up. Van der Orens in sixth place, and David Strijbos is in eighth place. So Holland's packing right in now, looking for six results from two races in the same way as America are.
vier Fahrer wie an einer Perlkette.
Die Start Nummer 10 geht weiter mit. Er greift das noch immer wieder an. Und da gibt es auch ein Duell.
Having a terrific tussle as America and Holland consolidate. Gert-Jan van Doren is right behind them in eighth place, the German champion is Roland Deepon in ninth place, the runner-up is the Suzuki World Champion Jackie Bimont in tenth place. And Rob Andrews, the second English driver at the moment, in 22nd place, and a bunch of riders in front of him to climb up the leaderboard still further. But Toby Thorpe still the leader. Case van der Ven in second place. Then the USA pairing of Dave Bailey and Jeff Ward in third and fourth position.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
with one lap to go, Kees van der Ven took the lead from Dave Thorpe over the jump right opposite the commentary point here. He went past Thorpe as if Thorpe were stationary. Kees van der Ven being the first man to beat the world champion since Thorpe became world champion. Kees van der Ven then the winner for Holland, Dave Thorpe in second place for Great Britain, in third place was Jeff Ward for America, fourth place David Bailey was Ronnie Lachine, so the Americans packing in fourth, fifth and sixth there, and to go with Thorpe's second place, he was Rob Andrews finished in 22nd position. So America packing in with Holland, and it's beginning to become a two-horse race. Bailey, who's down in 13th place, but America can only improve on the score of 11 that they've made so far. It can't be any worse, so it's looking a little bit as if they're favourites. The race from Kees van der Ven. Thorpe finding the way over the jump opposite to the commentary point here in a much better way in this third and final leg. Opening a gap now from van der Ven. Jeff Ward in third position. Michele Margaretto for Italy in fourth place. Fifth place is Roland Diefold of Germany. Sixth place Ronnie Leachin of USA, followed by Jukka Sintonen and Kurt Ljungqvist with David Bailey behind him. We're watching the progress of Rob Andrews, who
is in 21st position, just off our leaderboard, but looking good to give England a result at the end of the day. Climbed up into sixth place, but remember he started on the second row and he's already up into sixth position. Dave Thorpe, the race leader for Great Britain, Kees van der Ven, is still there in second place, but good news for Great Britain in that their second rider is now up into 18th place on the 125cc Kawasaki, which is his best placing so far in the racing. Jeff Ward though is there in third position, Michele Margarotto for Italy in fourth place, fifth is Ronnie Leachin, and sixth is David Bailey. So Great Britain intact with six placings from six rides so far, and keeping their fingers and their toes crossed for a good final position. But the race leader then, Dave Thorpe of Great Britain, with Kees van der Ven of Holland in second place.
Meine Damen und Herren, Sie erkennen also die meisten Buchstaben von den Bye.
Motos and three classes all mixed together, scoring and keeping track of team points was a nightmare. Regardless, when the last checkered flag was thrown, the U.S. team came out on top. Stiff competition came from runner-up Holland, with a host team, West Germany, finishing third. The new format was heralded by all as a huge success. Hopefully, in 1987, the motocross donations will be held in the United States, and hopefully, the United States team will make it seven in a row.
Das Bild nun zwar genau um 19:30 wenn die von Express abgelaufen wird.
von mir halten die Fahrerpokale des Veranstalters. Da sind drei riesengroße Biermesser. Und nun darf ich nach vorne bitten, den Drittplatzierten, und der kann das sein, ich habe eine Mannschaft, die